What is our lesson yesterday? Yes. So yesterday we discussed about the introduction of organic chemistry, right? So before we will continue, may I ask you, what do you mean by organic chemistry? Huh? Ano gani yung organic chemistry? Sino naka-screenshot? Anybody? Let's have a review. Review natin. Kasi kung wala talaga kayong natutunan kahapon, ulitin na naman natin ang lesson para mag-gets talaga. Hello?
Ako, sir.
Oh, yes. Mr. Brian. Very good. So, what is an organic chemistry?
Organic chemistry is a chemistry of carbon compounds, sir.
Okay. Very good. Yes, example.
Methane, DNA, insecticide, penicillin. Yan ang sir.
Okay, very good, Mr. Brian. So when we say organic chemistry, it refers to the carbon compounds, meaning our lesson focuses only in carbons. And carbons can be found in our DNA, in our blood, in the food that we eat. Even some human inventions such as penicillin, no, ano pa yon? Penicillin, mga dye, marami, no? And also, last meeting, we discussed about the carbon cycle, that we are rich carbon, we are rich in terms of carbon in the atmosphere, in the sea, in the oceans, in the mountains, so maraming carbon. So, pabalik-balik lang. So, that's what we call carbon cycle. So, for this afternoon, we will going to continue. Let's discuss the common functional groups in organic compounds. So, ano yung mga functional groups, no? So, we have here, can you see my PowerPoint? Is it too small or okay lang?
Gamay, sir.
Small, sir.
Ma-zoom man, sir.
Okay. Ah, ma-zoom nyo sa cellphone nyo.
Yes, hindi siya ma-zoom.
Ah, ang ibang cellphone, hindi maka-zoom. Ano kayong brand ng cellphone na hindi pwede ka-zoom? Kasi ito na siya yung pinakamalaki dito, oh. Sige lang, let's try, okay? Ma-zoom man yan niya. I-touch mo lang yung screen. Yes, matouch mo yung screen. Katulad ko ngayon, oh, gina-zoom ko ngayon. So, nakikita siya. Here are some example of functional groups. These are what we call the functional group. And here are the types of compounds. So, discuss natin isa-isa yung example para malalaman nyo. Di ba, yesterday, I told you that we will have a short recitation sana. Ready ba kayo or hindi? Hindi mo na ngayon?
Hindi, ready, sir.
Ah, hindi mo na. Ah, sige, next meeting na lang. Include ko na lang sa LMS. So, dapat nag-answer na kayo sa LMS ha? Kasi our activities in the LMS, ang deadline yan is on Saturday. So, I hope na nag-start na kayo answering. So, examples of types of compounds for functional group. Number one, we have the here, alkene. Tandaan talaga ninyo, alkene. Please take note with the suffix or the prefix, which is en. Kaya tinawag siyang alkene. Ayan, an example of an alkene is ito. Is that double bond carbons. Ayan siya. So, systematic name or common name for alkene, we have ethane or other term they called is as ethylene. Okay? Another example is alkyne. For alkyne functional group, triple bonds naman ang kanyang carbon on this side. So, ine, kaya nga Y-N-E, ayan, the triple bond. So, example of an alkyne is we have ethyne. Okay? Or other term is acetylene, the acetylene. Ito yung siya mga ginagawa din for acetone, no? Mga acetylene. Next one is the alcohol. Ito yung kanyang functional group for alcohol, OL. So, single bond siya, pero meron na siyang carbon, oxygen, and hydrogen. So, example of an alcohol dito, actually maraming type ng alcohol, pero ang binigay lang dito na example is methanol. Or common name for methanol, tinatawag natin ng mga methyl alcohol. Okay, pero usually, ito talaga yung kanyang structure. Another one, we have ether. Ayan, ether. Example of an ether is dimethyl ether, haloalkane or the halo, no? Example of a haloalkane, we have the chloromethane or methyl chloride, a combination of this one, carbon with chlorine, okay? Another one is amine, amine. Example of this is ethylamine, okay? Another one, we have the aldehyde, okay? Example of aldehyde is the ethanol or acetaldehyde. The ketone, we have here the own. Example of a ketone is the propanon or if the acetone pala. Acetone is a propanon. So, mali ako kanina, no? Kala ko doon na siya sa ethane na side. Next, another example is carboxylic acid, no? Oic acid siya. Example of this is ethanoic acid or yung mga acetic acid natin such as mga vinegar, no? Meron sila mga acetic acid sa mga lemon. Another one, we have ester, okay? A methyl ethanoate or methyl acetate, amide, okay? Or ethanamide or acetamide. So, in the entire lesson, since this is organic chemistry, pero general siya, usually, ito yung ating paglalabanan talaga. More on the structures tayo. Okay. So, we have the term homologous series, meaning all the members of a particular homologous series have, number one, same general formula. Example, ito lang yung usually na mga general formula natin for homologous series. Palagi may carbon, ano pa, may hydrogen, may OH. Sorry, nawala ako kasi may nag-interrupt, may nagtawag. I don't know sino yon pero hindi sinagot. Okay? So, let's continue. Sorry, class, ha? Please chat me, ha, kung may nag-accept pa. So, sobra na ba ng 20 minutes? 5:20 na ba? Sobra na?
Sobra anong oras na, sir.
Na? 5:20 sobra na. So, hindi na mag-accept na mga... So, hindi natin magpa-accept ng mga students na late. Okay? So, another thing for homologous series, aside from they have the same general formula, they have also same functional group. So, same chemical reaction sila. Example, all alcohols contain OH group. Yung kanilang mga chemical structures for alcohol, palaging merong OH. Kasi OH symbolize alcohol. Number three, each member differs from the next member by a constant. So, nag-iiba lang sila, no, differs from the next member. For example, CH2 na mga ganon. Pero ito, constant talaga si CH2. After CH2, doon naman mag-iiba ng formula. Number four for homologous series, as the molecular sizes increases, the boiling points also increases. So, kung lumalaki daw ang molecules niya, molecular size niya, the boiling points also increases. So, here is from the alkene nomenclature. Actually, may discussion talaga nito sa isang lesson, pero binibigyan ko lang kayo ng konting background lang. So, here are the first 10 straight chain alkenes. For example, tatandaan ninyo yung mga name of the hydrocarbons, their molecular formula, the number of carbon atoms, the melting point, and the boiling point. No? Kung gaano sila kadaling ma-melt at kaano din sila madaling mag-boil, no? Example, number one is methane. Ang formula for methane is CH4. Ang carbon niya, as you can see, isa lang, no? So, ang melting point niya is -182.5 degrees. Kung naabot yon na degree Celsius, mame-melt siya si methane. For boiling point naman, kailangan niya ng -161.6. Next one is ethane. Ito naman ang formula ni ethane. Ayan. So, nakikita nyo ang carbon is dalawa. CH3, CH3. Okay? Propane.
Sir,
tatlo ang carbon. Yes.
Numbers ang carbon of at ay number of carbon atoms. Paano ganin mabalaan, sir? Like para sa
bilangin mo yung letter C.
Ah, okay.
Bilangin mo yung letter C. Halimbawa, 1, 2, dalawang carbon niya. For,
opo.
Yes, for propane, ilan ang carbon sa propane?
Tatlo.
Very good. Kasi H3, CH2, CH3. Okay? Butane.
Okay, sir.
Yes, ang formula for butane, CH3, CH2, may parenthesis open, may dalawa pa, and CH3. So, a total of 4. 1, 2, kasi ito times 2 mo yung sa gitna, so 4. So kung sometimes ito yung when we say butane, ito yung ginagamit sa mga butane na yung ginagamit yung magluto. Are you familiar with that?
Yes, kaya
kung mag or sometimes kung maglabad ako, magbili ako sa tindahan, ante pabili ng CH3, CH2 times 2 times CH3. Amala, ano na butane? Kasi I'm referring to a molecular formula. Oh, di ba? Pwede niyo siyang gamitin. Another one is for pentane. We have 5 carbons kasi ang carbon dito 3 times 2 tayo. So 6. Ay, be. 1, 2 represents okay. So naka-parenthesis siya. So they are referring to 3 carbons. Sandali lang class, may nagatawag talaga.
Nadula si sir.
May nagtawag daw.
Ang kuta si sir kung paano makuha ng melting point.
May katawag daw. Melting point?
O, paano siya kuha mo?
One. Given na siguro.
Masabi siya, ano, may solving.
Hello, ayan na. So, wala nag-stop na, hindi man ginasagot. Hello?
Sir.
Ayan na, naririnig na ba ako?
Yes, sir. Okay, sir.
So, mali pala, yes, ulitin natin na nagkamali ako doon sa may parenthesis kasi hindi siya pwede, for example, for butane, hindi pala magiging 4 si carbon kasi yung subscripts na ito, yung number 2 is for hydrogen. So, si hydrogen pala ang 4 kasi 2 times 2, that is 4. Pero si carbon dito, still 2 siya, di ba? Kasi 1, automatic, alam natin sa mathematics na kung wala man siyang subscript, it represents 1. So, 1 times 2, 2 pa rin. So, kung bibilangin natin dito, kung 2 siya, 2, 3, and 4. So, we have 4 carbon for butane. For pentane, sige, check natin. 3, 4, and 5. Okay, correct. Yun siya. Hexane, from the word itself, hex, hexagon. Diba, hex means 6. So, there are 6 carbons. Ito ang kanyang molecular formula. Okay, for heptane, 7. Kasi 5 ito, i-times natin sa 5 yung sa gitna. So, 5, 6, 7 carbons. Naiintindihan niyo ako, class? Nagigets ninyo?
Sir, yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Okay, very good. Kasi mga fast learner. For octane, we have 8 carbons. 6, 7, 8. Nonane, 9 carbons. And decane, we have 10 carbons. Okay, questions? Wala na?
Yes, sir.
Sir, sir, paano makuha ng concept?
Sa boiling point daw, sir.
Isa-isa lang magtanong. Okay, yung boiling point, hindi nyo na siya isa-solve, that is given na. Meaning, a series of experiment, i-experiment niya nila, for example, si methane. Kailan siya mamimelt si methane? So, pinag-aralan nila and they found out na namimelt si methane in negative 182.5 degrees Celsius. So, that is given na. Naintindihan?
Yes, sir.
Ang mga chemist na ang nag-identify ng kanilang melting point and boiling point. Ito sila, yung mga hydrocarbons na ito. Okay? So, let's continue. Okay na? Nag-gets na? Hello?
Yes, sir.
Okay, good.
Yes, sir.
Sige.
Yes.
Now, so for formula of organic compounds, So please do remember that organic compounds can be complex. Why? A system is needed that shows structure. Kailangan talaga may structure. And we want something that is easy to read. So, paano natin ma-read ang isang organic compounds? So, pwede siya by molecular formula. Yung kanina pinakita ko, that is an example of molecular formula. From the word itself, molecules, meaning formula ng kanyang molecules. Second, we have the empirical formula. Also, we have the structural formula, ang kanyang mukha talaga, structure. We have also the condensed formula and the bond line formula. Example. So again, when we say molecular formula, it is the actual number of atoms of each elements in a molecule. So kung kanina pinapakita ko yung mga actual carbons nila in a molecule. So for example, for methane, how many carbon again? Methane. How many carbon? Ala, nakalimutan na. Si methane? Ilang carbon? One. Very good, Kobe. For butane, how many carbon for butane?
Four, sir.
Four. Very good, yes. Sige, correct. So meaning, that is the molecular formula. An empirical formula naman, meaning it is a simplest ratio number of atoms of each element in a molecule. Example, glucose. So, itong formula na ito, dahil may number ang kanyang mga atoms, so that is an example of empirical formula. May mga ratio talaga ilang carbon. So, we have C6H12O6.
So, glucose yan or table sugar. Kaya magsabi ako sa pinsan ko, pakikuha ng C6H12O6. So, kung magaling siya sa chemistry, alam niya talaga na that is a sugar.
O, diba, so siya, sa balay namin, hindi na sugar, kundi naka-formula, naka-empirical formula, yeah. Another one is, ito, mga example, this is glucose, and this one is CH2O. Okay. Now, for structural formula naman, it shows all atoms in the bonds, and the bonds are represented as a line. Gina-represent yung mga line, yung mga bonding nila. For example, we have here the propane. So, how many carbon do you see in a propane?
Three.
How many carbon? Three, very good. Ano pang ibang element aside from carbon? Yes, tatlo, correct. Aside from carbon, what other element?
Hydrogen, sir.
Hydrogen. How many hydrogen? How many hydrogen did you see?
Eight, sir.
Okay, very good. Yes. So, meaning, kung molecular formula yan, so ilalagay mo doon, there are three carbons, no? Sa molecular formula. And then, kung i-empirical formula naman yan, lagyan mo ng C3H8, kung empirical formula. Since structural formula siya, lalagyan mo siya ngayon ng bonding. So, anong mga bonding niya, class? Is it single bond, double bond, or triple bond?
Single.
Yes, very good. Single bond lang ang kanilang bonding. Single lang, kasi wala tayong nakitang triple. Tag-iisa lang, oh. Okay, so single siya. Okay, so propane, ang bonding niya, carbon to hydrogen, is single bonding. Now, a condensed formula naman, meaning it is a shorthand way of writing molecular formula. So the same with molecular formula, pero pina-shorthand lang siya. Example, we have here the CH3, CH2, and CH3. Okay, so ang tawag doon is a condensed formula. A bond line formula naman, as I said, represents structure between carbon to carbon bonds, and the atoms other than carbon and hydrogen are called hetero atoms. Example, ganito yan. So we have here CH3, CH2, CH2, and CH3. So, ang tawag doon na pag kung idodrawing natin siya pa ganito. So, let's start with here with carbon. So, ilang carbon ba? 1, 2, 3, 4. So, kailangan, tinuruan kasi kami nito before sa organic chem din namin. So, kapag mag-slash ka ng bonding, tagapunta is carbon. So, 1, imagine natin dito may carbon na isa. 2, 3, 4. So, ganun siya. 1, 2, 3, 4. Nagigets ninyo? Sir, saan makikita yung hydrogen? So, kung idodrawing ko yan, dito makikita ang isang carbon, Tapos may nakadikit dyan na tatlong hydrogen. Kung dito na may isang carbon, dalawang hydrogen. Kung dito na may isang carbon, may dalawa ditong hydrogen. Yung ganun siya. Okay? For another example we have here, CH3, CH2, 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 OH. So, ang paggawa natin yan, ilang carbon? 1, 2, 3, 4. Bilangin natin. 1, 2, 3, 4. Ang pinakalas is 4, OH. Oo. And OH, remember, ano gani yung OH? Symbol for what? For?
Oxygen, hydrogen, sir. Tama ba?
Hindi. 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 Ano yun siya na formula? Ang OH. Na-discuss natin kanina. Symbol for? Ano siya? Alcohol. Right?
Ah, okay.
Diba?
Alcohol.
Alcohol, OH. Oh, ito oh. All alcohol contains OH group. So meaning, itong example natin sa number 2, this is an example of alcohol. Okay. At least may natutunan na kayo, no? Actually, masarap. Masarap. I mean, ano yun? Exciting ang chemistry. Kapag ako, nalilearn ko talagang chemistry, when the teacher is, yung parang magaling magturo ng chemistry. Kasi kung halimbawa, kung medyo stricta, dati nakatry ko kay ilang chemistry ako sa pag-college ko, I have 4. Minsan, hindi din siya interesting kapag masyadong mahirap. O, basahin nyo na lang yung page, hindi niya gina-explain ng maayos. So, di ba napakahirap siya? Pero kung ganyan pala, ay ganyan pala ang meaning niya. Okay? So, yun. Let's continue. Baklas, or you find it very boring? Continue.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
No?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Okay, let's continue. Sige. So, we have here an example or what we have here an example of isomers. So, when we say an isomer, isomer actually are the different compounds that have the same molecular formula. Kasi as you can see, lahat ng mga carbon related to carbon in chemistry, pare-parehas na mga molecular formula. So, kaya nabuo yung term na isomers. Meaning, isomers, kinaklassify sila talaga in a different compounds. So, isomers is divided into two. We have here a structural isomers and stereoisomers. Okay, so let's start with structural isomers. Meaning, they are compounds with the same number of atoms and bonds, but please take note, with different arrangements. Nag-iiba lang sila ng pag-arrange. Example nito is C5H12. So, kung bibilangin natin, how many carbons it represents? How many carbons?
Five.
Hello? Five. Okay. Isang example, okay. Isang example nito is ganito. Bibilangin natin ang carbon dito. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Okay, 5 carbons. Parang gabi, hindi ka participative si... Sino bang nag-recite? Is it Johanna? Oh. Sir. Best in chemistry na si Miss Johanna. Grabe yun. Tutok na tutok and ano talaga. So, I love the spirit. Gusto ko na mga ganyan. Kasi, kasi parang chemistry kasi...
Grabe ka ba yun?
Pagka-math din kasi. Okay, yung hydrogen niya, supposedly there are 12 hydrogen. So, bibilangin din natin kung 12. 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. Okay, tama ba?
Yes, sir.
Tama, no?
Yes, sir.
Okay, so kung gagawa na siya ngayon, kung gagawa natin siya kanina ng, yung kanina na example we have here, the bond line formula, kung iba-bond line natin siya, kung 5 carbon, so dapat 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Okay, correct. Tapos sa unang carbon, may tatlong hydrogen, may dalawa, may dalawa, may dalawa, may tatlo. So, kapag ganito ang pagka-drawing mo, ang tawag natin dito is an N-pentane. Okay? So, another arrangement for C5H12 is ganito, oh. 2-methylbutane. Actually, the same din. Bibilangin natin ang carbon. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Tama din. Okay? Another drawing for C5H12 is 2,2-dimethylpropane. Ganito din. So, actually, pare-parehas. Kahit saan dyan, tama. O, Johanna, pakimute ng speaker mo kasi mabatayan din ang manok ang nagtuktulaok. Okay?
Sorry.
Hapon na. Maraming manok dyan, Johanna.
Oo, sir. Sa kapitbahay.
Ay, abi ko sa inyo kay...
Ay, meron sir, pato sa dyan. Amin. Pato at saka ano, manok din.
Taga saan ka?
San Isidro, sir.
Marbel!
Yes, po.
San Isidro. Alo, uy.
Bakongko, sir. Love... Bakongko, nationalized school.
Ah, Bakongko. So, I love patotin. So, na-teacher mo si Sir Jesse Galigo, eh? Ay, Bakongko. Ula, sila, sir, ano pala dito, sir Aguirre. Si Sir Aguirre and si Sir...
Yeah, Sir Danny.
Si Sir Escobillo. Sir... Escobillo. Sa Senior High School Agriculture. Hindi mo kilala? Escobillo ba na siya?
Hindi, sir.
Or...
Hindi, sir. Undi. Feel ko okay, kay Anna Tato, sir.
Hindi. Sa Bakongko siya, Senior High School.
Ah, okay.
Tama ba, sir? Ah, sige. Sige lang. Continue. Okay, so... Ang tawag natin dito is structural isomer, meaning they have the same number of atoms and bonds but with different arrangement. Kung nagkakaiba lang sa arrangement, so structural isomer. Another example, we have C6H14. O, ayan. Pwedeng ganito. Pang N-hexane from 2-methylpentane, 3-methylpentane, 2,3-dimethylbutane, 2,2-dimethylbutane. So, depende sa inyong ano. So, example of structural isomer. Another one is stereoisomer naman. These are compounds with the same molecular formula and structural formula, but, ano naman pinakaiba ya? With a different arrangement of their bond in space. So, nagkakaiba naman ngayon sa bonding in space. Example, okay? So, we have here, no? The same molecular formula and structural, almost the same, may double bonds dito sa gitna. Pero observe ninyo yung kanilang pinagkaiba in terms of their bond in space. At tawag kasi natin dito, bonding in space. So, H3C, ang partner niya dito, yung sa kabila sa H3. Pagdating naman dito, gi-change niya, H3C nandun pala sa taas, pero sa baba naman yung sa H3. So this one is what we call a cis, a large group on same side, no? Meaning nasa ang mga large group nasa labas tanan on the same side pala, upper portion. Trans naman if the large groups on opposite sides. So tatawagin natin trans and cis for stereoisomer. Okay. What else? So naming of organic compounds according to IUPAC system. Oh, meron ng mga pa-IUPAC. IUPAC system. Paano mag-name ng mga organic compounds? So, number one, we should identify the longest carbon chain and this chain is called the parent chain. Second, identify all the substituents or groups appending from the parent chain. Number three, the number the carbons of the parent chain from the end that gives the substituents the lowest numbers. When comparing a series of numbers, the series is that is the lowest, is the one which contains the lowest number at the occasion of the first difference. If two or more sides change are in equivalent position, assign the lowest number to the one which will come first in the name. Fourth, if the same substituent occurs more than once, the location of each point on which the substituent occurs is given. So in addition, the number of times the substituent group occurs is indicated by a prefix di, tri, tetra, and etc. Number five, if there are two or more different substituents that are listed in alphabetical order using the base name, so ignore the prefix. The only prefix which is used when putting the substituents in alphabetical order is ISO, as in isopropyl or isobutyl. So the prefix sat and tert are not used in determining alphabetical order except when compared with each other. So mamaya, tuturuan ko lang kayo. If change of equal length are comparing or competing for selection as the parent chain, then the choice goes in series 2. Letter A, the chain which has the greatest number of side chains. Second, or B, the chain whose substituents have the lowest numbers. Letter C, the chain having the greatest number of carbon atoms in the smaller side chain. And letter D, the chain having the least branch side chains. And number 7, a cyclic ring or hydrocarbon is designated by the prefix cyclo, which appears directly in front of the base of the base name. Kasi ngayon, parang ililearn naman natin paano pangalanan yung mga compounds according to IUPAC names. So first, dito na, yung mga binasa ko kanina, gin-summarize na natin, ito na yung result. So, first, i-identify natin yung may pinakamaraming carbons or pinaka-length ng carbon. For example, from the word prefix meth, it contains 1, F, okay, ang length niya, 2, prop, 3, but, 4, pent, 5 carbon, hex, 6 carbon, hept, 7 carbons, oct, 8 carbons, non, 9 carbons, and dec, 10 carbons. So, for example, ito, 1, 2, 3, 4. Tama ba? 1, 2, okay, 3, 4. So, this is an example of a butane kasi there are 4 carbons. So, the longest C chain has 4 carbons. And all C, a single bond C, bond or a single bond. So, ito nakikita nyo, kapag nagko-connect sila, these are single bond. So, the parent name of this structure is what we call butane. So, tama ko kasi apat. Oh, 1, 2, 3, 4 carbons. So, CH3 on second, ayun, kani itong first kasi, pag second, may nakabanding dito na CH3 that on the second carbon. So, the IUPAC name is 2 meron kasing 2-methylbutane. So, on this part, this is what we call the 2-methylbutane. Why 2? Kasi dalawang carbon and then meet, meron pang isang carbon doon. 2. Kasi ka number 2 na siya. So, 2-methyl, the overall is butane. Yes.
Paano damol ang, ano sir, ang parang CH3 pa, ano sa CH? Nandaring apart, sir, oh.
Number 2?
Oo,
anong change? Siguro pag drawing lang ito, pero actually, basta isa lang siya na drawing, so that is a single bond. Ang importante is yung bonding. Basta kung nagdalawa yan, double bond, bonding. So, it refers to single. So, ang pangalan nito, kung kanina, tatawagin natin siya butane, pero more specific pa, tatawagin natin itong 2, kasi meron pa nakakabit na CH3, isa pang carbon, kasi lahat dito, halimbawa sa number 1, hydrogen and carbon lang. So, okay lang yan, disregard. Ito sa number 2, dalawa na kasi na carbon. So, i-consider natin yung may nakakabit na isang carbon. So, isang carbon lang siya. So, nandun siya sa family ng methyl. So, tatawagin natin ito sa number 2, siya na stage, 1, 2, 3, 4. So, tatawagin na siya 2-methylbutane. Butane kasi apat lahat, di ba? Apat na carbon, nasa family of butane. So, 2-methylbutane. Okay? So, as I said, another example we have here, the longest chain is 6. Sa second figure na tayo, ha? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So, anong family siya? Kay 6 siya. This is? Anong tawag natin dito? Sa 6. Hexane. Yes, correct. This is hexane. Pero observeran nyo, yes, sa number 2, may nakakabit na naman isang carbon, and sa number 5, may isa pang carbon. So, dalawa methyl groups ito, kasi tig-isang man. So, ang tatawagin natin kung dalawang methyl groups, that is dimethyl. Okay, naintindihan? So, dahil nakakabit siya sa number 2 and number 5, sa formula na ito is 2,5-dimethylhexane. Naintindihan na? Bakit, sir, 2? O, ayan ang 2. Naka-number 2. Sa 5, nasa 5. Di siya kasi dalawang carbon. Tapos, nagsisingle pa talaga na carbon. Methyl. So, dimethyl. Overall, ang tawag is hexane. Hay, grabe no, ganyan lang pala mga carbon. Makakalurky ang mga carbon. Ang hirap palang pangalanan. Ganon. Pero at least enjoy, no? Okay, so tawarin siya 2,5-dimethylhexane. I hope na nagigets ninyo at na-absorb ninyo. Actually, pang grade 1 na gani ang treatment para ko ha, para maintindihan. Ano?
Medyo ano dasig yun? Ang gamay, sir. Pero okay lang.
Ay, dasig. Dasig na pala yun. You know what? okay. Our professor before ha in MSU, hindi na yung tinuro sa binigyan na kami ng libro. Oh, i-research yung paano pangalanan yan.
Tapos,
as in, ganun. So, ang ginagawa namin,
oh my God.
Ang technique namin before, minimemorize namin itong mga prefix. Kapag one siya, that is methane. Palagi namin ginememorize yan. Kung two, ethane. Three, propane. Four, butane. Five, pent. Kasi sa mathematics, ganun din. Kung five, di ba, pentagon. Kung six, hexagon. Meaning six sides. Kung seven, heptagon. Kung eight, octagon. Yun na lang ginememorize. Gina-combine na lang namin ang math and science. Kung nine, nonagon. Kung ten, decagon. The ten sides. So, the same with chemistry, kung ganito karami ang carbons niya, bibilangin namin, hala, siyam na carbon, so, no, non-name, o. Diba? O, enjoy lang. At least, hindi naman yan, hindi naman siya sumusobra kasi makaabot talaga ng 20 carbons, ba, mamatay na ito, mapuno ng papel ko kasot sa mga carbon. Diba? Imagine. Okay? Okay, konti na lang before we end. So, here are the types then of organic reactions, no? So, for organic reactions, siyempre nagre-react din ang organic kapag ina-applyan din natin ng iba. So, we have here the general, no? Meron siyang rearrangement, meron ding elimination, meron ding substitution, and sometimes addition. Okay? So, itong letter green naman, kapag specific na naman siya na reaction, meron nangyari na hydrolysis, oxidation, that is esterification and hydrogeneration. So for example, si diamond is a good example of a carbon. So kung dadagdagan mo yung halimbawa yung carbon niya, so mafo-fall siya sa addition. Kung may tatanggalin ka, substitution. Ganun ang mga process kasi sa carbon. Example, palagay natin this one. Let's have, bakit siya tinawag na addition? There are two substances react together to form a single substance, no? Example ito, this is an example of an ethane, no? So, dadagdagan natin na may gin-add tayo hydrogen at saka bromine. So, later on, nadagdagan, no? Nadagdagan na ito ng kanyang extraction. Pinasok natin si bromine, tapos nagdagdag ng isang hydrogen, at ito na ang kinalabasan niya ngayon. So, kanina originally, apat lang na hydrogen, pero ngayon, ilan na ba? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, naglima na kasi nagdagdag tayo ng isang H at ng isang Br pa bromine. So, ang tawag na dito is a bromoethane. So, yun ang mga processes or reactions sa mga carbon. Pwedeng dagdagan. So, ang tawag na yun, addition. Another example is substitution, no? Meaning, an atom or a group, living group in a molecule is replaced, no? May paalis na mga grupo kapag meron tayong ipare-replace by another atom or group o nucleophile or electrophile, ang tawag naman doon is substitution. May nag-sub. Example dito, how many carbons ba ito? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Ang pinaka-5 is bromine. So, there are only 4 carbons. So, dito, tatanggalin natin ito na side. Actually, this is an HO. This is a bromobutane. So, magli-leave na ito, papalitan natin si bromine ngayon ng OH. So, alcohol. So, tatawagin natin ito is butanol. So, ang nagawa natin, gin-replace natin dito, tinanggal si Br, ni-replace ng HO. So, from bromobutene, naging butanol. So, nag-separate na si bromide ion. So, this is an example of substitution. Gipalitan natin. Elimination naman, from the word itself, eliminate, meron tayo tatanggalin, meaning there is a removal of atoms or groups of atoms from a saturated molecules to form an unsaturated molecules. Example, nangyayari ang mga elimination. Yes, Geracel, naka-open ang mic mo. Time na ba? Parang gusto mo na ako ipastop, Geracel. Time na ba, class?
Sorry, sir.
Wala pa, sir.
Ah, wala pa. Konti na lang. So, sige. 6 minutes. So, ang sometimes, nangyayari ang mga elimination during dehydration of alcohol. So, paano? Paano tayo mag-eliminate? So, originally, ito yung formula ng butanol, CH3, CH2, 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 OH. Ngayon, ang gagawin natin, meron tayong i-eliminate dito, naging CH3, CH2 na lang. So, natanggal ito. Halos ito, ginawang water. Okay? So, naging butene. So, ito na yung formula niya. So, ano bang na-eliminate dito? CH2OHO. Magipang eliminate siya na ito na part. So, ito siya butene. Another one is rearrangement. no? When we say rearrange, may gi-rearrange mo. Another term for that is by nang mag-migrate. So migration of atom, may nag-migrate na atom or a group of atoms or a bond from one atom to another within a molecule to form its isomer. No? Example of this is a tautomerism of ketoethanol. For example, this is a propanol, no? Propanol CH3 double bond sa CH2 with OH, and then later on pagdating dito na rearrange siya, nag CH3 pinalitan na yon, nag CH2 na, dinagdag na yung kanina dito na OH, dinagdag na ng H doon sa CH2, so nag CH3 na siya, double na dito. So from propanol, kung i-interchange natin o rearrange, magiging propane na siya. Okay, what else? Ito naman kanina for bigger or specific reaction. Number one is hydrogenation. Addition of hydrogen to a multiple bond to form a single bond substance. Kapag ang isang carbon, no, dinadagdagan ng hydrogen, no, so a multiple bond, no, para ma-form lang ng single bond, so ang tawag natin doon is hydrogenation. Example. So this is an example of ethylene, no, CH, ayan, plus dadagdagan natin ng hydrogen. So ang mangyayari, single bond na puro hydrogen, from ethylene naging ethane. So tingnan nyo, ilan na lahat ang hydrogen? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So this example is hydrogenation. May pagdagdag ng hydrogen. Esterification naman ang tawag if it is acid catalyzes ester formation between alcohol and carboxylic acid. Meaning, from ester formation, acid catalyze, kinakatalyze natin dito yung between an alcohol and our carboxylic acid. Okay. So, ayan na. So, parang nakaka-nosebleed na sa inyong part. Basta importante, alam nyo lang what is hydrogenation, esterification, meaning ester naman siya, wala ng hydrogen. Another one is oxidation, an increase in the number of bonds between carbon and, please remember, oxygen, and or decrease in the number of a carbon-hydrogen bond. So, for example, chlorination of methane. So, example, this is our methane, this is chlorine. So, kailangan meron siyang increase in the number of bonds between carbon and hydrogen. Okay. So, magiging CH3Cl, that's what we call chloromethane plus hydrogen chloride. So, or else, we have decreased in the number of a carbon-hydrogen bond. So, tandaan nyo lang, basta oxidation, nag-oxidize ka. So, example of that is chlorine and methane. The last one is hydrolysis. Hydrolysis meaning chemical process in which a molecule is split into two parts by the addition of a molecule of water. Dadagdag tayo ng water. Kung kanina hydrogen lang, this time water. Ang formula kaya ng water is, anong formula ng water? Sige nga, it's basic two. Yan. Very good, John Dave. H2O. Yes, so kung magbili ka sa kantina, pabili ng H2O. Kung mahina siya sa chemistry, they can get it. Kapag merong yeah, process, splitting of two parts, tapos dinagdagan ng water, so that is hydrolysis. For example, this one, CH3, CHBr plus, dinagdagan natin ng H2O, so ito na ngayon yung formula niya, kasi meron tayong isang lesson talaga na i-discuss natin yung mga pagdagdag, pagbabawas. So, merong hydrogen bromide. Kapag merong ganito, na-split ito, yes, tapos nagdagdag ng water, so that is an example of hydrolysis. So saan natin application of organic compounds? So organic compounds can be related to biology and biochemistry. Saan pa? For polymers, yan, hindi siya masyadong, for agriculture, so marami. So actually, organic chemistry is very important, no? It helps a lot. Yun nga lang, medyo, kung wala ka talagang love sa mga molecules and chemicals, sometimes, sasayin mo, ay, ano ba ito, kahirap, no? Pero, enjoy, actually, no? Only intelligent people can know about this. No, sabi ko nga before, sino bang nag-handle ng chemistry sa CREAM? Inoon, meron talaga mga chemistry major teachers sa handle, pero meron din mga mathematics teacher who handling chemistry. Pero you know what? Kapag ang magturo sa chemistry is a major in math or another major hindi matuturo talaga yung science concept. So it should be taught by a science teacher. Kasi iba, kahit sabihin natin magaling ang mga math teachers in solving, pero sa chemistry kasi hindi man lahat solving. No, there should be an application of science. Okay, any questions or clarification? Pero tanong? Hello? Wala na. So, okay. Tomorrow is our asynchronous schedule. Wala tayong klase. Please, answeran ninyo ng mga activity natin doon sa LMS. Kasi mag-close siya on Saturday, exactly 1 o'clock. Okay, so for our pictorials, please turn on your camera. Ayan, sino yung inutusan ko na mag-capture ng picture? Sino?
Francis, sir.
Okay, sana siya. Paki-count, Miss Santi. Ayan, very good yung iba, oh, naka-headset, naka-set up talaga. Christmas na Christmas sa bahay ni na Brian Tanquerido, may Christmas tree sa likod. No? Advance Merry Christmas.
Merry Christmas, sir.
Okay.
Kalag-kalag pa, sir.
Wala nang kalag-kalag kasi close ang mga cemetery. Natapos na ba? Nag-screenshot na ba? Sino yung nag-screenshot? Baka nag-leave. Sino gani dapat yon?
Si Oro, sir. Si Francis.
Oro, sir. Saan na siya? Andito pa ba si Oro? Tapos na ba nag-capture si Oro?
Sir, why pa, sir?
O, sige, dalian mo, Oro. Pagsabi ka ng 1, 2, 3, and smile.
Sir. Why man ang iban ka? Open cam, sir.
Oh, sige, papayin na lang, hindi na mag-open. Oo, yung meron lang. Para may ebidensya, ako talaga na nag-meeting tayo nag-klase. Okay na?
Okay na, sir.
Okay na? Okay, so thank you so much for your attendance. Hindi ako magbibigay ng assignment or quiz. Just answer the activity in our LMS. Okay, bye-bye.
Bye, sir. Thank you, sir. Thank you, sir.
Bye, sir.
Thank you, sir.
Sir, kompleto kami ni sir ba? Sana all. Sana all ba? Yot.
Wi-Fi ga-reply. Wi-Fi mga ga-reply, yot.
Jamay ka ba?
Sir, all in one kami ni sir.
Joanna, may pagkaon ka da?
Ipanot, ibandre.
Ay, nakagawa ang manok pa, hindi ka na kung madakpan.
Ay na. Babay na sa inyo, mga lim.
Shalom.